Praise the Lord, everyone. Thank you for tuning in with Dr. Leisha, the preacher. Okay. Again, thank you so much for watching me. You know, I thank God that, you know, I have a few people that watch my videos, you know. Now, do I desire for thousands of people? Heck yeah. I do. But I am so thankful for the 442. I'm sorry. 242. Did I say 442? Maybe that's coming faster than I think. No, but I have 242 subscribers. And I'm thankful for all the subscribers, especially the ones who actually watch my video. You know what I mean? Out of the 242, there may be maybe like 30 people that happen to, you know, come across my videos and take time and at least watch a few minutes or something. You know what I mean? And I'm thankful for that. I'm not complaining at all. Okay, so I'm going to go to the next beatitude. And so let me go ahead and do a quick prayer as we come out of Matthew chapter 5 and verse 7. Okay, verse 7. Heavenly Father, Lord, thank you for your word. Lord, open up our understanding, open up our minds, our hearts to hear what you have to say. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, guys. All right, so we've gone through all these other beatitudes, and now we are at merciful, merciful. Blessed are the merciful. Again, that's Matthew chapter 5, verse 7. For they shall obtain mercy. Mercy is so important. Mercy is so important. And let me tell you why. I have some supportive scriptures. Psalms 41 and 1. So let's flip over there. Psalms 41 and 1. Yeah, this is just old school Bible study. You know, we just tell what the scripture is and go to it. You know, read it. And we're discussing it, okay? Psalms 41 and 1. Blessed is he that considereth, meaning continually, you know, continually considereth the poor, you know. The Lord will deliver him in time of trouble. Praise God. Praise God. So, you know, the best of us, I mean, like, even the best of us, not that I consider myself, you know, in that group or anything, but even the best of us, those of us who's always considering other people, we always helping other people. We're always forgiving people, giving people chances, you know, chances to do right. Because we're always communicating and, you know, what's going on. You know, we're open and honest about what's going on so that people can learn what to do better. And when people learn, there may be several lessons, you know, that they need to study through in order to get it, you know. So, you know, blessed is he that considereth the poor. You take in consideration the circumstances around the decisions they make, around the decisions that are made over their lives. You take in consideration, you know, the circumstances that they're under that lead to, you know, certain mindsets and behaviors kind of thing. You're considerate of it. The Lord will deliver him in time of trouble. So even the best of us will get into some trouble at some point. Yeah. none of us are too good to experience some trouble. But if you have a good track record of considering other people, guess what? God got your back. Even when you fail miserably. Like I failed miserably. The past 10 years of my life has been like, what? You know what I mean? And I have suffered greatly. I mean, I have suffered to no end. You know what I mean? Now, I may be dramatic, you know, in my expression, but, you know, I lost a lot of respect from people. I mean, you know, I was considered one of the good people in life, but over the past 10 years, going through the stuff that I was going through, I lost a lot of respect. I lost, you know, there are people who don't even want me around them. They don't even want me around. And I'm like, really? Wow. You know, I'm just thrown. You know what I mean? However, thank God that I don't have a track record of just letting people go easy. I normally consider people, I usually show mercy, you know. I help people on their good days and I help them on their worst days. You know, a person can be at their worst. I mean, like, absolute worst. And I'll be right there. I'm known for that. You know what I mean? So, I'm going through a long period of trouble. A long period of trouble. But you know what? God is delivering me. He is. I can say that God is delivering me. He is. And I believe He's restoring me. He's restoring my image, my reputation, everything that I lost during my time of trouble. I believe God is restoring it. Now, will some people, you know, continually hold, you know, things against me? Yeah, they will, and they still are. It is what it is. Okay, so we're going to go to the next scripture, which is Matthew 6 and 14. And it's a part of the Lord's Prayer. Matthew 6, 14. For if you forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. I believe God forgives me. I forgive other people. I forgive them, you know. Even if they are still holding things against me, it's okay. You know, I'm going to forgive anyway. And forgiveness is a process. It's not just a simple, I'm sorry. And then just walk away. You know, it's a process. And I have the forgiveness video that I can attach here too. And I did a reading recently, the last energy check. Forgiveness came out of that. So, but yeah, being merciful, according to Matthew 5 and 7, blessed are the merciful, those who consider others and are forgiving. Ooh, Jesus, Lord. For they shall obtain mercy. A part of consideration and forgiving is, like I said, all that stuff I said, you know, you are considerate. You take in consideration the circumstances around the trouble, around the issues, the lack, you know. All right. And then we're going to go to, I think we're just going to go to those two. Yeah, I think that's plenty right there. Forgiveness and just considering others. Considering others that are less than you, you know. And what's going on with me, you know, 10 years ago, I had my first suicide attempt. And after that, I've had others. And my mental health issues is just too much for family and friends. They just can't understand how I may respond to the troubles in my life. You know what I mean? And, you know, and that's being held against me, you know. And I try to explain to them that, you know, I do the best I can. You know, a lot of things were triggered in my life. You know, for a while, and, you know, I acted out, you know, and my acting out was distasteful, and, you know, and it's leaving me in a position where I've lost a lot of relationships and respect and things like that, but, you know, that's how people respond to me, but do I respond the same? Not necessarily. But I will respect the fact if no one wants me to be bothered with me, I'm not going to force myself on somebody that don't want to be bothered with me. You know what I mean? I have to respect their boundaries when it comes to me. I must respect their boundaries. It's a part of the forgiveness process, you know. So, God is good. Thank you for his word. Hallelujah. For the merciful. Because when we're in trouble, God got us. He got us. Because there may not be anyone around that shows that level of mercy for us. The level of mercy that we show other people, we may not get it back. And because we may not get that level of mercifulness, because we may not get that back, God got us. He gonna deliver us from our troubles. When other people aren't there to deliver us from our troubles, God is. I have a fresh, spanking, brand new tarot deck. You know, it's the Rider-Waite tarot deck. A spanking brand new. I just came from the store. So let me go ahead and light my sage. Sage these cards. I'm so excited. There's nothing like having a new deck of cards, you know? Because see, my other cards, I wrote all over them. Took notes and stuff. My very first deck. I took a bunch of notes and wrote all over them and stuff, so this deck here, and then that deck is in Florida. I've been in Michigan for a few months handling business, you know, finalizing things in my life, and, you know, accepting all the changes that I've been going through and all that. So let me go ahead and light my St. Michael candle for protection. Okay. All right. Hallelujah. So I'm going to go ahead and start this reading with, because this is a scripture reading. So, you know, God is merciful. He's merciful to those who show mercy to others. And, you know, we each know how we've been merciful to others. You know, we know that. We know what we've done. And we don't have to always. I mean, it's good to testify. There's nothing wrong with, you know, testifying. We're supposed to testify. But even in the case when we're not really, you know, talking about what we've done for others or how we were considered or merciful. It's not that you're bragging. It's called testifying. But, you know, it's not about bragging, you know. There's nothing wrong to talk about that. I know we live in a world that you ain't got to tell nobody what you do for me, and I ain't got to tell nobody what I did for you, and all that kind of stuff. It's not that big of a deal, really. It's nothing to be embarrassed about. Oh, here's one. Nothing to be embarrassed about. You're calling. You know, I believe those who are merciful, they're called to be. Some of us are called to be merciful. You're calling. And out of these beatitudes, because we have to have attitudes for Jesus. Beatitudes, okay, for Jesus. You know, some of us have multiple beatitudes. You know, I resonate with this merciful one. I do. Mm-hmm. Even though I don't receive a lot of mercy in life. Now, have I had some merciful moments? Yeah. Have people showed me mercy? Yes. But I don't seem to get it at the rate that I give it. You know what I'm saying? But it may be a calling on me. And that's why I may be more merciful than other people. Possibly, you know what I mean? Because it's my calling. It's your calling. If you resonate with this, it's your calling. And don't worry about how merciful other people are with you or not. Don't worry about that, because who's going to deliver us? God. He's going to deliver us when we are in trouble. Your calling, your life's purpose is like an awakening to put your gifts and talents to good use and enjoy the journey of life. Being a merciful person, you know, can feel like a burden sometimes. It feels like you may wear the weight of the world on your shoulders or something. But, you know, it's a gift from God, though, you know, so you may as well enjoy it, enjoy being merciful. And again, when you're in trouble, don't expect those same people that you've given mercy to, don't expect for them to bail you out or help you out, because guess what? It may not be their calling to do it. It may not sound fair, but we have the most merciful of them all. God, angel of action, because merciful people tend to be action people. I mean, we're like the movers and the shakers. You know, we get things done. When other people are sitting around trying to figure stuff out, we already got our hand to the plow. We already doing it, making things happen. While other people are trying to figure it out, we already making things happen. Angel of action. We're being guided and led to do things, to consider things. When other people are clueless, we're taking it into consideration already. Take action toward your destiny. Yeah. You know, we got to learn how to enjoy being the type of leaders that we are. Okay. And then we have look up, look forward. Merciful people, we're like visionaries. We think things through. We take things in consideration. We don't just like blame people for nothing. If we see that people are in trouble with the law, in trouble with, you know, in relationships or whatever, you know, we're willing to sit down, talk it out with them, help them see their errors, you know, we're visionaries. Welcome new developments for positive change. We're always trying to find solutions. We're not afraid of the problem. We don't fear problems, and we don't fear being wrong or when people are wrong. We don't fear evil. Merciful people do not fear evil, for the most part. Because if we feared evil and couldn't find solutions and stuff, we wouldn't be able to be the visionaries. We wouldn't be able to look up and look forward. We wouldn't be able to focus in on our calling. You know, we need mercy. We need to have mercy with one another right now. We all need to take in consideration each other, you know. Angel of action. We got to be ready. We got to be ready. Ready when Jesus comes. Well, we already know Jesus already came, but he's supposed to be coming again. But, you know, for reasons that, well, let's go to tarot and see. Now, this deck is spanking brand new, so, you know, I don't know what card just popped out of here. I put it back in there because I'm still shuffling. You know, it's spanking brand new, so they're all in order. So, let me get it a couple of good shuffles. You know what, let me go back to this scripture real quick. I just want to go back because I had read another scripture, and I think it might make sense in here. Before I go into that tarot, hallelujah. Let's go to, let me just go there real quick and see if that's the one I want to read. Oh, check this out. Okay, I'll read this one. Hebrews 6 and 10. For God is not unrighteous to forget your work. God don't forget what we do in labor of love. He know the work and labor of love that each of us do. Even when man, women, children, other people in our lives act like they forget what we've done, when they act like they don't remember how we sacrificed and what we did for them, you know, how merciful we were. When other people forget how merciful we were with them, God don't forget. God do not forget, which ye have showed towards his name, in that ye have ministered to the saints and do minister. Again, merciful people, you know, we don't mind talking about the hard stuff. We don't mind dealing with the problems. We don't sweep stuff under the rug. We confess our faults to our brothers and sisters. Most people don't want to talk about problems, especially more than once. People feel like if you mention something more than once, then you just won't let go of the past. No, we just ain't resolved the problem. Some people can resolve the problem in one day. Other people, it can take years to resolve problems, depending on your communication skills, depending on how honest you're being, depending on how upfront you're being. If you're not communicating and you're giving people the silent treatment and you're not, you know, giving the gift of a voice, giving your voice that God give you, giving you the insight that God give you to share, then, you know, there's no growth. How are you ministering, you know? When people don't let you know exactly what you've done wrong or what you keep doing wrong, that's not showing mercy. Mercy is when people tell you, they let you know what you've done wrong. And not only tell you, but help come up with solutions and monitor these solutions. You know what I mean? Holding each other accountable. Bam. Okay. Hallelujah. All right. Let's see here. Let me see if there's another one. I think there's one last one. I wasn't planning on reading these, but you know, here they are. Okay, here we go. James chapter 2 and verse 13. And then we're going to go into the tarot. For For ye shall have judgment without mercy, that hath showed no mercy. And mercy rejoiceth against judgment. See, people, again, you know, when you're wrong, or you have a, you know, you got to confess your faults to one another and stuff. Through that process of judging each other, talking through the problem, you know, when we're talking through the problem, people feel like, you judging me. No, I'm just talking through the problem. I'm trying to talk to the problem so that we can reach a solution. You know, but it's really hard for people to look up and look forward. It's really hard for people to be merciful, you know, be open and honest. And it's really hard to take action. You know, it's more than just saying, I'm sorry. I'm sorry about what I said. I'm sorry about what I did. But you need to get over it. Oh, do I really? How about, can we talk through it? Can we come up with some solutions on how we're going to interact with each other going forward? You know what I mean? It's called the forgiveness process. Can we go through this process so we both can heal and still be friends, still love each other, still have relationships? People don't know how to do that. People are not willing. I think people should talk about stuff as much as they need to until they reach, you know, a solution enough to, you know, have a relationship. Four of Cups. See, people be stingy, unwilling to talk, unwilling to receive godly instructions, you know, solutions. I mean, you know, you can get so far in life. You can only get so far. And then at some point, you gotta open up. See how he's all closed up. At some point, you gotta open up with your emotions. You gotta show some mercy. You gotta be willing to forgive. Forgive what? You gotta talk about it. You gotta be specific. You got to talk. You got to be specific. You got to communicate. You got to open up. You can't be all closed. Thank God for those who have the gift of mercy to deal with. You know, see, people like me, we're going to communicate. We're going to talk. We're going to express ourselves to no end. We're merciful. We consider everything. We're willing to forgive, but we want to be specific on what we're forgiving. But most people don't want to talk about it, not more than once. They may admit one time, I was wrong. Get over it. Forgive. Whoa. Okay, that's good, but mercy calls for communication. Mercy calls for consideration. Mercy, the calling of mercy, calls for forgiveness. It's a process. It could take one day, it could take years. But being all silent and closed up, emotionally unavailable, gets you nowhere. You can't have a healthy relationship under those circumstances. You just can't. Hallelujah. Wow. Angel of action. You gotta get to work. You gotta work at solutions. You gotta identify the problems and you gotta work at getting the solutions. And again, these solutions should be measurable. After about a week, a month, a year, you should be able to see evidence that forgiveness has taken place. Forgiveness is a process and a plan of action. Especially on that big stuff. Like lying, silent treatments, cheating, stealing. Some stuff just can't be brushed under the rug. Some stuff got to be talked about open and honestly. And it has to be a plan of action that is measurable. Boom. Y'all tuning in with Dr. Alicia Preacher. Because again, when you look up and look forward, it's all about being merciful so that we can rejoice and don't have to live under such harsh judgment. We need to be able to rejoice. But again, you have to respect each other's boundaries. When people are like this, they're all closed up and don't want to talk and come up with solutions. It's hard to get to a happy place. If you want to be happy, a happy family, a happy community, a happy church, have a happy workplace, you got to have a vision. You got to be merciful. You got to be forgiving. You got to be able to open up and communicate and be sincere about it and be committed. Be committed to a plan of action. Yeah. Well, I'm glad my new deck of cards came out so good. We got the Ten of Pentacles, Earth Energy. We got the Four of Cups, Water Energy. And then we got more pentacles or, action oriented, Yeah. I mean, you have to work. You got to work to be a healthy family. It takes a lot of mercy, forgiveness, talking things out. This is not the way to be a happy family. This is what tear families apart. Being closed off, closed up, silent, won't even apologize to people for what you did. I've asked people to apologize for X, Y, and Z, and they're like, no, I'm not apologizing. No, I'm not apologizing to them. I mean, I'm being merciful by pointing out what needs to be done. And they're like, no, I'm not apologizing. Okay. Alrighty. So, with that being said, I'm going to put a little healing on this because, we want to be merciful. We want to be healed because mercy leads to forgiveness. Mercy leads to rejoicing. Rejoicing from judgment. Rejoicing as a family with no judgment. But it takes more than just, well, first of all, it takes, if you're gonna apologize, it's gonna take more than, I'm sorry. It's gonna take more than that in a lot of situations. But you at least gotta be willing to apologize. I have apologized to so many people. You know what I'm saying? And some people don't even, they're not used to extended apologies. The kind of apologies where take a accountability. Joy, we gotta rejoice. Be joyful. Be willing to be merciful, willing to be considerate, willing to talk. You gotta be willing. Turn this silent, cold, detached type energy into joy. Free yourself. Free yourself. Know what your calling is, especially mercy. But those of us where we're merciful, we're forgiving, we talk things out, we come up with solutions, we have a plan of action. God will deliver us. He will. Because what? We're resilient. We're resilient. We're willing to work. We're working for the Lord and we're resilient. He has a plan for us. He has a plan. He going to get us out of trouble. Because we all get in trouble. We all, you know, fall under some type of judgment. We all need mercy. We all need, you know, an escape. We all do. The best of us to the worst, and from the worst to the best, we all need mercy at some point. We all do. And, you know, those of us who are visionaries and we're looking up and we're looking forward for solutions, you know, to be happy families, you know, we're sincere about this. We're sincere. People are not bringing up what happened to be hurtful. We're bringing it up so that we can heal from a sincere place. It's called mercy. Lord, have mercy on us. Allow us to be able to talk about our problems. Allow us to be able to have solutions. Help us, Lord. Help us. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm going to end this message right here. Hallelujah. Lord, just help us to be sincere when mercy is in the presence. Help us to open up and be sincere. Allow us to trust you when we can't trust each other, which we don't have to, you know. We need to trust God that his gifts among us will lead us to happiness, the pursuit of happiness. Someone recently told me that that movie, The Pursuit of Happiness, remind me of that movie. You know, that movie remind them of me. I'm like, really? They just see me, you know, I have suffered and suffered, and now there's some, you know, small breakthroughs coming here and there for me. And they're like, gosh, you suffered and suffered and went through so much. Now you're coming out on the other side. You know, you're looking better. You know, you're sounding better, you know. I'm like, thank you, Lord. You know, there's some happiness for me, even in the midst of all the rejection and bad reputation and loss of respect and, you know, just being looked at as a crazy woman. You know, the crazy woman nobody want to be around. You know, I'm still going to have a moment of joy here and there. Do I still have sad moments? Yeah. Like, I can be riding high all day. I mean, like yesterday, I was busting all kind of moves. You know, I had different contractors coming through and, you know, just feeling good. And then I just had a moment of like, whew, wow. You know, just kind of being set back a little bit. But I'm sincere. And God is delivering me. And he's going to restore what he is willing to restore in my life. And I'm thankful for whatever he restored. Even if it's all 100% not restored, I'm glad for whatever he bring back. Return to me. I'm glad. You know what I mean? I'm thankful. You know. Joy, especially joy, you know, and being resilient, you know. Yes, sincerity. Okay, all right, guys, I'll keep on going. God is good. Thank you. If you need a personal reading, I still do personal readings, yeah. You know, I'm not that big yet, you know. I don't have like thousands of, you know, subscribers yet, so I'm in that zone where I'm still doing personal readings. And so if you need one, you can email me at drleisha@gmail.com. And if you've been blessed by this message and want to send me a love offering, thank you to all those who actually do. Thank you. I mean, you're like few and far between, but it do happen. I'm like, thank you, you know. So my Cash App is $DrLeisha the Preacher. Thank you, guys. Bye. Love you. Love you, love you, love you. Love yourself. Self-love and self-care is so important, especially when you are in hermit mode, isolation mode. That's what it's for. It's for you to reflect and, you know, and care about yourself, you know, rebuild, recharge, and get back out there. Get back out there. Get back out there. Use your gifts. Remember your calling. Whatever it is, all these beatitudes we're going over, you fall in some of these categories. Get to work. Get to work. Don't let what happened cause you to lose out with God. Don't lose out with God now. All right? Okay, love you. Bye.